In the news, ethylene oxide as a sterilizing agent. Some geezer made a little clip where he found the packaging of a swab for testing. He finds EO, which stands for ethylene oxide for sterilization. He looks up ethylene oxide and finds it is a cancer-causing agent. Oh my God! No. Yes, indeed, it is a cancer-causing agent, but it is one of the many sterilizing agents that are available. And they used to use formaldehyde, but they still do. But in this case, they use ethylene oxide instead of formaldehyde or even steam, which can also be used. There are some advantages and disadvantages that I don't know about. But what I do know about, being a chemical engineer and having worked in the gas industry for 10 years with equipment, I can look up these substances in references like this one. There's a chemical chart, it's a Dutch standard work on chemicals and safety. Ethylene oxide is in here and has a maximum allowable concentration, a MAC value, of 50 ppm. That is for a working environment. 50 parts per million is allowed. In comparison, if you take something like ammonia, which I looked up earlier, it has 25 ppm. So ammonia is considered more dangerous. And pretty much every kitchen cabinet has a bottle of ammonia, and we breathe it in when we work with it. So, what's the panic all about? But, more specific, we want to know about cancer. And then I reference this little booklet, an American book called Poisoning and Drug Overdose. I call it the Olson, the main editor. And it also provides information on working surroundings, and it has a table of known or suspected human carcinogens. That's what gives you cancer, if you're unlucky. Number one, ranking from 10 for meh, up to 1, that's a first place would be for TCDD, tetrachloro dibenzo dioxin. You cannot simplify it, but it happens so much in the press that they just refer to it as dioxin. And dioxin itself is meh. It's the chlorine atoms that make TCDD such the worst chemical that humans can produce. So please, don't simplify chemistry, because what happened with this substance? I found a PR work of some French chemical producer, and in that work, reassuring the general audience that dioxin is something that will be produced during a campfire. This is what happens if you simplify chemistry. You cannot. If you don't know the difference between nitrite and nitrate, step away from the chemistry and bring in someone who knows. Now, looking up with number one place, TCDD, we find ethylene oxide ranking number 7. It's in there with other chemicals. There's a complicated one. On number 6, we find another substance called formaldehyde. And formaldehyde is something that we also are breathing in daily, because it comes from I believe you call it corrugated board with wood chips glued together with some sort of resin that outgasses formaldehyde. So be careful what you choose for the furniture. I use solid wood surrounding me. It's also used for making these hard types of plastic that you use for camping outdoors. And there's probably some formaldehyde coming out of this one too. But as you see, I am using this and it's no biggie for me. So, in other words, there are worse chemicals than ethylene oxide also when you look at cancer. Much worse, if you want. And it doesn't really look that dangerous in comparison to other chemicals like we see, like we are confronted with daily. So please, next time, don't spread this false information. It makes you look stupid. And if you don't understand chemistry, bring in someone who knows. Thank you.